Hello, this is Megha Pandre and welcome to the second part of this video of the chapter lesson number one, socio-religious reform. And we will continue with the explanation of Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda, a spiritual genius, a commanding intellect and power. A Bengali graduate named Narendranath Dutt came into contact with Ramakrishna Paramhans, who reciprocated his quest for knowledge. So he fulfilled his search for knowledge, was fulfilled by Ramakrishna Paramhans. Narendra became a disciple of Ramakrishna and became an ascetic. So, and after he became a disciple, follower of Ramakrishna Paramhans, he became a sannyasi. Later acquiring the name Swami Vivekananda, he did an intensive study of the Indian and Western philosophy. So Swami Vivekananda was having the knowledge of both Indian as well as the Western philosophy. Swami Vivekananda advised people to serve the poor and look for God in the needy people. He imbibed pride for our rich cultural heritage and faith in a bright future in the Indian youngsters. He attended the Parliament of Religion in Chicago in the United States in the year 1893 CE. With his influential speech, with his powerful speech, he provided understanding about the Indian philosophy and culture. He propagated the Indian culture by touring various countries. So what did he do? He spread the Indian culture by touring various countries like the United States, Europe, Egypt, China, Japan, etc. He was an ardent supporter of the Indian culture and devout nationalist. Ardent means very enthusiastic, and devout means dedicated nationalist. He gave the legendary slogan to the Indians, "Arise, awake and stop, not till the goal is achieved." Swami Vivekananda established the Ramakrishna Mission in Kolkata in the year 1897 CE in the name of his guru. It has its headquarters in Vellore. This mission adopted the ideals of service to mankind through various work. The mission followed the slogan, "Service to man is a service to God," by gaining motivation from the life of Ramakrishna Paramhans. So they have followed whatever was being taught by Ramakrishna Paramhans. This mission opened schools across the nation for imparting education. Hospitals were run by the mission to help the people in need. Even today, the branches of the mission are functional in India and abroad. Till today, this mission is serving the mankind. We will continue with the reformation movement in the Muslim community. We will go through the explanation part of what type of reformation movement started in the Muslim community and what was the role of Haji Shariatullah and Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan in this reformation work. In the early 19th century, social and religious reforms were initiated in Muslim community under the leadership of people like Haji Shariatullah from Bengal and Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan from Rai Bareli in Uttar Pradesh. They were motivated by the preaching of religious leader Shah Waliullah of Delhi. They believed that the Britishers could establish their rule in our country as the Islam in India were becoming weak and corrupted. They started Wahhabi movement in order to strengthen the Islamic religion and culture and also to make it purer. Many Muslims started acquiring English education due to the impact of the Wahhabi movement and the growing influence of the Western culture. However, due to the orthodox nature of the ulema, now who are these ulemas? Ulema is a Muslim body of Muslim scholars who are recognized as having specialist knowledge of Islamic law. A large number of Muslims remain deprived of the English education, social awareness, and reforms. That is why education of Muslims and the subsequent rise of middle class was not satisfactory. Sir Syed Ahmad Khan was born in an aristocratic family. Aristocratic means people holding hereditary titles. During the revolt of 1857, he was serving the East India Company as an employee and had remained loyal to the company. After his retirement in 1869 CE, he went to England and was influenced by the liberal ideas of the West. He advocated the idea of acquiring English education as a means to reform the Muslim community, because if you want to change the society, only education will lead to. He advocated the idea of acquiring the English education as a means to reform Muslim community of its orthodox attitude and backwardness. He started a magazine called Tehzeeb-ul-Akhlaq in 1870 CE. He established the Aligarh Muslim College in 1875 CE, which is also known as Aligarh Muslim University today. He translated the book of English literature and science in Urdu language and tried to make the Muslim familiar with the branches of knowledge from the West. He opposed the veil system. He even opposed the burqa pratha and child marriage and advocated education for girls and widows to remarry. Next is the Sikh community. The reforms of the 19th century also influenced the Sikh community. Shiromani Gurudwara Prabandhak Committee was formed with an objective to reorganize the religious practices and remove the evil practices from the Gurudwara. So this organization was formed to impart English education along with the religious education of the Sikh. Khalsa College in Amritsar was established along with many other schools. Here we will start with the reformation work started in the Parsi community. The Parsi youngsters who had acquired English education established Rehnuma-e-Mazdesne Sabha in 1851 for socio-religious reform movement, and Dadabhai Navroji was the leader of this Sabha. This Sabha had started a periodical named Rashta Guftar. It gave an impetus to the reform movements and carried out work for the awakening of the Parsis. K.R. Kama and Behramji Malbaring also contributed in the socio-religious reform. Kama laid emphasis on the propagation of education and Malbaring emphasized on women empowerment. They opposed child marriage and encouraged widow remarriages. Due to the effort of Malbari, the government passed a law fixing the minimum age of marriage in 1891 CE. Another social reformer of the 19th century, we will talk about Jyotiba Phule. Jyotiba Phule was a well-known social reformer of Maharashtra. He started a school for girls in Pune in 1857 CE. He helped the widows to remarry. He challenged the authority of the Brahmins in the society, because during those days, the Brahmins were having more power or more dominance in the society. He established the Satya Shodhak Samaj in order to inculcate confidence, courage, and enthusiasm in people. Now, the next reformer is Thakkar Bapa in the 19th century. Thakkar Bapa's contribution as the head of the Akhil Hind Harijan Sangh established by Gandhiji was very valuable in the upliftment of the untouchables. He worked tirelessly to provide relief to the people affected by natural calamities. Amritlal Thakkar, popularly known as Thakkar Bapa, was born in 1869 CE in the city of Bhavnagar. He remained dutiful and devoted servant of the people throughout his life. He was an engineer who left his lucrative job to serve the downtrodden and marginalized people after being inspired by Gandhiji. He was so much influenced by Gandhiji that even he left his profitable job. Thakkar Bappa established the Panch Mahal Bhil Seva Mandal and tried to reform the lives of the Bhils who inhabited the deep forest and the hilly areas of the Panch Mahal region. Thakkar Bappa and his followers freed the Bhil from the addiction of alcohol and other evil customs and superstitions. And the reformers, the people who used to help Thakkar Bappa, also helped the people living in the forest area to free them from the addiction of alcohol and customs, evil customs and superstitions. He opened school for the Bhil children. He taught them how to operate a spinning wheel to produce khadi and involve them in small cottage industry so that they can earn out of it. As time passed, awakening and nationalism spread among people, which connected them better with the freedom movement. And this is how the people, those who were living in the interior places, were also involved in this freedom movement. Gandhiji's emphasis upon the removal of the untouchability improved the condition of the people from the backward classes. Gandhiji believed that once you will remove all these practices from the society will grow. And here I end up with this chapter. Until then, goodbye.